Good evening. As executor of the Elvis Presley estate, I was asked to host this show. And it is my pleasure to bring you a very special program. Since Elvis Presley left us, a lot has been said and written about him. Some of it accurate, much of it sheer fantasy. But instead of dwelling on fabricated theories about Elvis, let's try and understand why he is still loved by so many millions of fans around the world. Tonight from his home, here at Graceland, we will share a lot of extraordinary footage. Some of it private, much of it never before seen. This special features Elvis's greatest gift, his talent. We will see the story of Elvis's life as a performer, an artist, and a very human being.
And now, Elvis, the great performance.
One for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go.
15 years, we have finally learned to understand what you say on record. Signed, RCA.
Elvis, the Great Performances, is hosted by Priscilla Presley.
Inside Graceland, the home Elvis bought at age 22, these walls were Elvis's protection from the outside world, and it was here that he spent a large part of his life. Today, it's still home to Elvis's Aunt Delta, who lives just down the hall. Graceland is the most famous home in the United States after the White House. Now, that says a lot about how people still feel about Elvis Aaron Presley. To understand who he was and where he came from, we have to go back. Tupelo, Mississippi, where Elvis was born. In a small town with a population of 6,000, lived Vernon Presley and his wife, Gladys. At the height of the Depression, twin boys were born to the Presleys, but only one survived. Elvis and his parents lived in a small two-room home built by Vernon. When things got tough and Vernon couldn't find work, the family headed 2 hours north to Memphis, Tennessee. Elvis was 12 years old and owned little more than a guitar. He was immediately drawn to the blues singers on Beale Street. While attending Humes High, Elvis's classmates saw the first hints of his musical talent at the senior class show.
I'd just gotten out of high school, and I was driving a truck. I was studying to be an electrician. One day I was driving a truck and I had a lunch break and I went into a little record shop and I made a record.
How I long to be with you.
In the summer of 53, Elvis was just 18 when he stopped by Sun Records, paid $4 and cut this song, a gift for his mother, Gladys.
Whether the skies are gray or blue, any place on earth will do. Just as long as I'm with you, my happiness, a million years it seems have gone by since we shared our dreams, but I'll hold you again. I'll be no blue memories then. Whether the skies are gray or blue, any place on earth will do. Just as long as I'm with you, my happiness.
We're in the television and music room down in the basement. Elvis heard that President Johnson watched three televisions at once and decided to install a similar setup for himself. But this room is very special for another reason. It's here in this corner that Elvis kept his record collection. Here's the original of Flip, Flop, and Fly by Joe Turner, which Elvis performed in his first television appearance. Elvis's interest in these rhythm and blues 78s changed music history. So did Elvis's first record producer, Sam Phillips.
Elvis Presley was exactly what we needed at Sun Records. We were ready to get out of the studio, and Elvis just kind of wheeled around and cut out on That's All Right, Mama. And man, this was just Presley on his guitar, and he could wail the heck out of a guitar. And I kidded around a little bit like, we've been all these months and you had this in your soul. We had it in a take or two, and that was it. And from then on, did you know, Elvis Presley was the easiest person, I guess, to record I ever recorded.
Well, the guy put the record out in Memphis, but nobody had really heard of me, so I was working for about a year and a half in nightclubs and football fields, barns, losing a hayride, yes, sir.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do it, that's all right. That's all right. That's all right, Mama. Any way you do. Well, Mama, she done told me. Papa done told me too. Son, that gal you fooling with, she ain't no good to you. But that's all right. That's all right. That's all right, Mama. Any way you do.
He'd be all just nervous as he could be, and we'd stop to get a hamburger or, you know, whatever. And somebody would have to kind of walk down the road to him a little way and kind of, I guess, would have burn him out until he got tired, because he couldn't sleep much at night. And if he didn't sleep, we didn't sleep. We had to kind of walk him down the road a little bit to kind of wear him out. But then he'd sleep like a baby for 6 or 7 hours, and we could drive on.
Before Elvis appeared on television, he toured the South promoting his records. This is Elvis at a typical Saturday night gig at a high school in Lubbock, Texas in 1955. It truly was an amazing night captured on film by a fan. Elvis is backstage with his band and a few friends who would later become rock legends. Carl Perkins, who wrote and also had a hit with Blue Suede Shoes. There's a very young Johnny Cash, who had just recorded his first record. Also present, local hero, Buddy Holly, before he formed his band, The Crickets. These are probably the first motion pictures ever taken of Elvis.
Colonel used to take shows out on the road. He'd hire me for an extra added single.
Mm-hmm.
And he undoubtedly liked the performance that we did, so we decided to start working together.
Colonel Parker masterminded Elvis's rise to stardom and arranged for him to appear on the Dorsey Brothers Show, his first national television appearance.
Next, Elvis's recently found screen test and the hip-shaking controversy. By J.C. Penney.
Upside down. For the first time, he had money in his pockets. And he did what most American guys would. He bought a brand new car. It wasn't just any car. It was a blue Cadillac that Elvis told the salesman to have repainted pink. This is it. It still looks great, doesn't it? Over the years, Elvis bought hundreds of cars, most of which he gave away to family and friends. No matter what changes Elvis went through, this pink Cadillac remained a constant in his life. He kept it to the very end. And it's come to symbolize not only Elvis, but 50s rock and roll.
There were two or three
columns this week, the carried item is that you had bought four Cadillacs.
In the years before, I just, you know, maybe someday I'll go broke and I can sell a couple of them.
I understand you gave one of them to your folks, is that right?
Well, anything that's mine is theirs. I mean, all four of them is theirs.
Welcome to the Milton Berle Show with tonight's special guest, Elvis Presley. And here's the host of our show, Admiral Milton Berle.
Here's a young man who in a few short months has gained tremendous popularity in the music business. His records are really going like wildfire. He's America's new singing sensation, our new RCA recording artist. Here he is, a big reception for Elvis Presley.
This show was lost for over 30 years. It highlights a great version of Elvis's first number one smash.
Well, since my baby left me, will I find a new place to dwell? Well, it's down at the end of Lonely Street.
In 1956, Elvis began touring from coast to coast. No matter where he went, fans wanted to see him and reporters had questions for him.
You see, Elvis Presley, being mobbed by teenagers, is coming up to the... What is your concert tonight? How long a duration will it be?
The entire show will be about 2.5 hours. I think I'm on for about 40 minutes.
Which song do you think is the biggest right now?
Don't Be Cruel is the
Don't
biggest.
Be cruel?
Yes.
How about Teddy Bear? How's it doing?
It's about 2 million now.
We have a bunch of teenagers up the other side of the studio are waiting to see you, and as you can see, in spite of all the secrecy and this little devious plan, that a lot of it's leaked out. So I think
yes, it always does. It always does, but I don't mind it. In mm-hmm. fact, if you come into a place, there's nobody there to meet you, you start wondering, you know.
Surely.
Very nice talking to you, sir. We're going to have to run. Here.
All right. Thank you.
By April 1956, Elvis was a phenomenon and Hollywood came knocking. Paramount Studios arranged for Elvis to travel west for a screen test. This recently discovered film shows Elvis before he was slicked up for the movies. His guitar is just a stringless prop and his hair has not yet been dyed black.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoes. Let's go, cat! My car, drink my liquor from an old fruit jar. Well, do anything that you wanna do, but honey, lay off of my shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoes.
for my blue suede shoes. Rock it! For the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, 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 but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but take the help of my blue suede shoes. Well, it's blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Yeah! Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but take hold of my blue suede shoes.
Before Elvis and the Colonel left town, they had a three-picture deal with one of Hollywood's most respected producers, Hal Wallace. Back in Memphis, Elvis had a small circle of friends with whom he felt more at home.
When I was clowning around with him during the rehearsal and he was doing Love Me Tender, I said, Love Me Tender, or you gotta be a hound dog, a hound dog. He kept looking at me. He said to me, Mr. Burl, he was very cute, do I sound like that? I said, yeah, pretty close.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Well, you ain't never gonna love it, and you ain't no friend of mine.
When Elvis appeared on his second Milton Berle show, this performance created such turmoil that some newspaper columnists predicted Elvis's career would end just as quickly as it took off.
Well, they said you were high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, they said you were high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, you ain't never caught a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
This apparently was what the fuss was all.
Hi, Gardner calling.
On your personal appearance, did you create a sort of mass hysteria amongst your audiences of teenagers? Is your shaking and quaking in the nature of an involuntary response to this hysteria?
Would you say that again, sir?
Well, I say that when you shake and you quake when you sing, is that the sort of an involuntary response to the hysteria of your audience?
Involuntary?
Yeah.
Well, I'm aware of everything I do at all times, but it's just the way I feel.
And at this time, it gives me extreme pleasure to introduce the new Elvis Presley. Here he is.
On Elvis's next television appearance, The Steve Allen Show, Steve decided to play with Elvis's image and had him dress up in white tie and tails. Being a good sport, Elvis reluctantly went along with the gag.
Elvis, now I want you to go sing. What are you going to sing for us first tonight?
I want you, I need you, I love you.
Here's the big RCA hit.
Die every time we're apart. I won't.
I love you with all my heart. Oh, well, I thought I could live without romance until you came to me. But now I know that I will go on loving you eternally. Would you please be my own? Never leave me alone, 'cause I die every time we're apart. I want you, I need you, I love you with all.
When the ratings for the Steve Allen Show went through the roof, Ed Sullivan picked up the phone and called Colonel Parker. They made a deal for three historic performances. Elvis was paid an unheard of $50,000, and the first of the three live shows was recorded at Television City in Hollywood.
They were happy and thrilled that their man was being protected by Ed Sullivan's partner, who flew 3,000 miles to photograph this spot. And I saw a most magnificent young creature. Eyes that pierced you, looked at you straight in the face, didn't waver. Very anxious to learn or to please or to show what he had without any hang-ups. And Colonel Parker brought him to the studio and we set him up with his group and he was very appreciative.
The classic teddy bear and Elvis from the waist up only.
Before producer Hal Wallace could get a script written for us.
Now, folks, what would you say if I were going to sing another song now?
Many fans were surprised that their rock and roll hero would appear on a Frank Sinatra special right after coming out of the Army. When Elvis sang one of his new ballads on the show, he decided to imitate old Blue Eyes himself.
When I hold you and me,
but the touch of your lips on mine makes me feel like a king. Your kind of love is a treasure I
'60s, Elvis starred in one film after another, a total of 27 pictures. Throughout his career, Elvis rarely socialized with celebrities, but on those few occasions when he did, he enjoyed the company of fellow performers. One of the artists who most influenced Elvis was the great rhythm and blues singer Jackie Wilson. When Elvis adapted some of Jackie's now famous moves, Jackie was on the set watching.
Return to sender. Return to sender. I gave a letter to the postman. He put it in his sack. Bright and early next morning, he brought my letter back. She wrote upon it, return to sender, address unknown, no such number, no such zone. We had a quarrel, a lover's spat. I write, I'm sorry, but my letter keeps coming back. So then I dropped it in the mailbox and sent it special D. Bright and early next morning, it came right back to me. She wrote upon it, return to sender, address unknown, no such person, no such zone. This time I'm gonna take it myself and put it right in her hand. And if it comes back the very next day, then I'll understand. We're writing on it, return to sender, address unknown, no such number, no such zone. Return to sender, return to sender, return to sender.
And I made some movies, you know, G.I. Blues and Hawaii and several pictures that did very well for me. But as the years went by, I really missed the people, the audience contact. I really was getting bugged. I was doing so many movies and I couldn't really do what I could do. You know, they would say action and I'd go, what, what?
In the 60s, Elvis made two or three films a year, but most of our best times were spent at Graceland. Thank you. In the spring of 1967, Elvis and I were married. Our wedding took place in Las Vegas on May 1st.